You ain't got that, you can sit with us, yeah. Sign the frames, make you double take. Man and Andy on a double day. Grams hit me, city on the way.
And now, three five-minute rounds of the UAE Warriors Women's Flyweight Division. Introducing first, the fighter on my left, fighting out of the blue corner. She is a mixed martial artist, sitting 5'3" tall, weighing in at 56.7 kilos. Her record, 1 win and 0 defeats. Fighting out of Maasai, France, by way of Tunisia, Ona Fatouhi. And now her opponent, fighting out of the red corner. She is a kickboxer, standing 5'5" tall, weighing in at 57.1 kilos. Her record, 0 wins and 1 defeat. Fighting out of Trabzon, Turkey, she is the Turkish fighter, Sabriye Şengil. Referee, when the action begins, Braintree.
Second women's fight right now, Daniel, it's Turkey versus Tunisia. God, it's almost the same, 5'5" and 5'3", here we go, round number one.
Ready?
Our referee is Frank Trigg, here we go. Cyrus and Stone once again for the women's fight.
Yeah, we love it, man. Yeah. They bring a certain type of fire to the cage, no doubt about it. And a lot of swag coming from both fighters. I love the entrances, especially Şengil fighting out of Turkish, man. She was walking down that aisle with a purpose. You know what I mean? She got some swagger to her.
Yeah, oh, look at those haymakers.
Şengil is an amazing striker. She's 5-time national boxing champion.
Wow. Wow. Kind of reminds you of Clarissa Shields right now, who's really doing some big things with Bellator.
Yeah, she's a Bellator veteran.
And she's got a kickboxing record of 15 wins and only one loss.
And Şengil is also an actress. Amazing.
Wow.
Yeah, she looks real comfortable in there, to say the least. Wow, you gotta like the aggression here of Mona Fatouhi, trying to derail that hype train.
Fatouhi is putting pressure against the cage.
Fighting by way of Tunisia, another
she's
nation.
She's a sharp striker. Yep.
Sabriye Şengil from Turkey. She's got 400 plus thousand followers.
Oh,
wow. Instagram, yeah. She is a social media star, buddy.
No, she certainly is. I need to get on with her, man. She needs to retweet a few of my things. You know what I'm saying? Let's get these numbers
That's
up.
That's right.
Let's get some followers, you know, cross promotions. Let's keep posting your stuff.
Here we go.
Get some repost in.
Mona Fatouhi, my goodness. Bringing the heat here to Şengil. She don't care how many followers she has.
Oh, wow.
She don't have a great time, you know, catching that knee. Using takedown. Got both of their feet again.
Ladies want it bad here, being featured here on our UAE Warriors Arabia 3 card. And we really got a good thing going on here with Arabia, man. We are seeing some incredible fights, great fighters that just bring it.
This is all about, sir. Just bring the new talents. Just give the opportunity for the Arab people just to grow and to shine in MMA.
Yeah, no doubt. Oh, wow. Oh, that was a solid one. That was a good strike,
left
though.
And right, right on the target by Sengu.
151 left, first round.
Sengu should, second women's fight. She looks more relaxed, more confident.
Oh.
I think Fitoi get a little bit sloppy when she throw punches. She's just giving a little hope for counter. Nice takedown attempt, perfect timing, but she gets.
This one, you kind of get that feeling that this one might not go the distance. You know, I mean, this looks like one that we may get some TKO here for sure.
Sengu just look really, really sharp, really comfortable. She's alert. Look at her eyes. She's just looking like a predator there. Like she's ready. Like.
Yeah, she's very dialed in. Ooh, nice one too. You can tell that boxing background.
She started to monitor. She started to telegraph a little bit. She wants to take down, which is very dangerous.
Both ladies just really pouring it on with barely 30 seconds left in round number one.
Nice.
Are we going to find out the next Fiora Manon with these new ladies coming into promotion? Let's find out. Oh, wow.
Nice. Body kick.
Mona Fatui bringing the heat here, and she's going to, it looks like she's going to end this round in the dominant position up against the cage.
Yeah, Mona is really trying. She's really trying, but
yeah.
She needs to bring something else, something more. This is not enough to be Sengu. Sengu should won this round.
And yeah, Sengu looks like pretty fresh. Too. Yeah, she looks solid.
She's dominated. She dominated.
Tunisia and Turkey here, duking it out in the middle of our UAE Warriors cage. Of course, guys, remember, tomorrow night, it all happens again. Man, if you didn't get enough tonight, then tomorrow night you are going to be blown away.
And what's even better, actually, is that we've got a nice packed arena right now. So a lot of people ask, can they watch live here at Jiu-Jitsu Arena? Yes, you can, as long as you're fully vaccinated and you've got a green color on the Al-Hassan app, which means you're negative from COVID.
Wow, okay, yeah, so.
Yeah, exactly.
We're taking all of the necessary precautions to make sure everybody's safe, from the fighters to the staff, and obviously to the audience too. All right, yeah. Coming up is round two.
Which UAE Warriors is always doing great on safety and organization, like.
Yeah, it's been a priority ever since COVID happened. We've had a number of shows that have been in empty arenas, and we had to do that. But we want to keep our fighters busy, and I think that's what Fuad and Ryan, you know, our matchmaker, he wants to keep these fighters busy. He knows that this is how they make money, this is how they earn a living.
Yeah.
So we're going to try to give them as many fights as possible, and kudos to everybody here in this organization
for making it happen. For the fans too, you know, everyone loves you and you Warriors.
I mean, there was one event that I couldn't even come to, I mean, because of, you know, the travel restrictions.
A year ago. I remember that was a year ago,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I hated it, man. It sucked bad, but I totally understood what it was all about, and I'm just glad that they kept these fighters going.
Once again, guys, Sengu is just, she looked more sharp.
She looked more calm, actually.
Yeah,
look at
calm,
her now. She's calm,
moving around.
Yeah, she knows what she's doing.
And Mona Fitoni, she's doing a good job on keep the pressure in the cage, but this might wear her out.
True.
Just be in that situation for too long.
Still not a lot of action happening right now for both fighters.
Yeah, I think Mona Fitoni just trying to initiate the clinch. I think she's expending more energy than Singula.
She definitely wants to take this fight to the ground, but she's having a hard time.
She's talking, I can
hear it.
Stop time.
All right, referee Frank Trigg has seen something in there.
Oh, he got some little animation out of the corner of Morocco's.
The corner looks very, very.
Oh!
And now here comes Fatouille again, doing what she does best, bringing the fight to Sengul. She has to do some damage, guys. I mean, it's one thing to initiate.
Stop! Time! Separate.
All right, I think we're gonna have a deduction here. Oh, that's gonna cost her a lot.
I didn't see what happened.
Is she grabbing the cage?
I don't know, guys.
She was actually.
Maybe the elbow on the back of the head, I don't know.
You know, sometimes, Daniel, these one-point deductions...
That can change the whole fight.
Exactly.
That can change the whole fight.
Yeah.
You need to play the rules, man.
Exactly.
You cannot have a mistake like that. That can cost the fight.
Oh, absolutely.
You train so hard for this. You need to be aware of the rules.
I just got confirmation from Helmy. Yeah, it was grabbing the cage is what she did.
Yeah.
And he warned her specifically
to not hold it.
Yeah, and then she did it again. So. But I don't know what advantage she was getting by grabbing the cage because she had her back against the cage.
Yeah, it's hard to tell, man. Maybe it's just...
I guess not to get taken down, right? I mean, that's what
that is. Just, I don't know. Wow. I don't know. They should be aware of the rules because, that, like Steve said, they can cost the fight. You need to be aware and play the rules.
Single, still showing that pinpoint accuracy.
So here we go. And now Frank Trigg watch very, very closely. If she grabs hold of that cage, he'll take another one. She doesn't want to be taken down, clearly.
Yeah, but she's doing well on the takedown defense. Grabbing the cage is unnecessary.
I think she just at this point needs to outlast Fatui, because Fatui is expending all of her energy, all of her gas tank looking for takedowns.
Maybe sometimes, guys, this is just a reaction.
Oh, here we go
maybe
again.
She don't even think about
it.
She
watching.
Just grab the cage as a reaction. She don't be taken down.
And her corner has to communicate to her as well in her language. Listen, don't touch the cage.
That's how important is the corner at this moment.
Now this is where Sengul wants to be. She wants to be in the middle of the cage, measuring her shots and boxing.
Exactly.
And she's trying to shuck off Fatui. Easier said than done. Fatui is just like a bulldozer. She doesn't stop.
Yeah, but Mona is doing, spending a lot of energy on his takedown attempts.
Just under a minute here left in round at number two, and what has been a grind, right? This has been one of those really rough, grinding type fights. And Sabria Sengul really needs to battle back. She lost that. If she can at least take this on the card, she's going to lose that point. It'll be a draw round, basically. It'll be a 9-9 round.
20 seconds on the clock right now, second round.
And I don't know that Fatui's really done anything to win a round. That's the thing. It's just a whole lot of attacking the clinch.
Yeah. Trying to go for a takeup and then nothing's still happening here.
Fatui have a good, she have a good timing. Catch the leg, but she
end of the
doesn't.
Round. So, Dan, what are your thoughts?
Well, you know, there it is. That's the end of round number two. And guys, you know, lean in here because this has been such a crazy fight. And this is like one of those fights that you prepare for in the gym over and over again, right?
Yep,
something that will not let off of you. And I have no doubt that, you know, they've been scouting Mona Fatui, and they knew that's what she was going to do in this
fight. Her hair.
That's exactly what she's doing. So, but the point is
okay.
that the point was deducted. That could be a major problem here yeah. for Cingul. So,
well, let's see what happens in the third and final round, you know, unless she gets a knockout here. But I don't really know what the outcome is going to be because first round, well, Cingul got, here's a replay. We'll see what happens over here.
Yeah, all tied up.
Yeah. They're good straight in there.
Yeah, like I said, you know, our judges are so much more advanced. They're always learning. And the real key to victory now with the unified rules is how much damage you do. Yeah. It's not going for takedown. Sometimes just getting a takedown doesn't score you enough points with a judge. You have to induce the damage.
I agree, man.
So, I mean, if you want my opinion, I would probably go Cingul on the round, but she lost the point, so I think it's a 9-9 round.
So maybe so, yeah.
All right, here we go. Third and final round.
Must be a draw.
But I'm just an announcer.
Yes.
So.
No. Yeah.
So what do we know?
What do we know? We just know how to entertain.
Oh. She loves doing that.
And here comes Fatui again. She has got to have better lateral movement to Cingul. She cannot allow Fatui just to attack her legs like that.
I think referee Frank Trigg is saying something again.
Well, and it's in Cingul's head as well. She keeps looking over to Frank Trigg. She doesn't want to make a mistake.
Yes.
And even that's going to take her out of her game plan. Yeah.
Like her eyes look so
she's
wide
like,
open.
I'm not doing anything.
Yes.
My kids do that to me all the time. They're like, no, I didn't do anything. I didn't do it.
And by the way, her corner should just go, be calm, moving around. You win in this fight. But just don't commit any mistake again, because if you lost another point.
Well, you know what's exciting is that after the women's bout, we're going to have the big boys coming up, middleweight and heavyweight divisions coming up.
Bring it.
I am excited for that.
Oh, that's nice.
Nice.
I like the big boys too.
Yep.
All tied up here, all pretzeled up against the cage. And Cingul needs to take the center of that cage. She needs to keep sticking and moving.
I've never seen Fatui really throw some
heads down
strikes in there.
She's always
go for a takedown. Yeah. Takedowns have a takedown.
She's the better fighter. She's dominating. She's striking. She's hitting the target. The only thing Mora is trying to do is taking down. And she's not able to complete that.
I have a feeling that Fatui is really feeling the heat right now as far as her gas tank getting depleted.
Yeah.
She's breathing very hard. That type of fight style can wear you out. And
yes.
Mouth open, breathing through her mouth. Yeah, she's feeling it right now. And Cingul needs to take advantage. Halfway through round number three, as Cingul is taking control of the fight again. And now Fatui doesn't really have the energy to reverse her and put her up against the cage. I think Cingul needs to separate and do what she does best here.
I agree. But anyways, hands up for the two ladies. Put an amazing show, amazing display.
Next up on the card, SMSM taking on Kier Khalifa, Esushan, and then it'll be heavyweight action between Hassan Rahat and Muhammad Juma. And of course, Muhammad Asali, the future, is in our main event out of Dubai. He has been a must-watch fight TV. You know, I mean, this is a guy you have to watch. He's a 6'5", athletic. He's got all the tools to be a complete star here.
Yeah. And he just began his MMA journey. So, you know what we say? He calls himself the future. The future is bright, indeed.
Very bright, yes, no doubt.
At 6'5", 23 years old, he's solid as a John Jones.
Yeah, and he's at middleweight, which says a lot. It really does.
50 seconds left here in this round between Sengel and Fatui.
It's been a grind. It's been a war of attrition between these two ladies. It hasn't been that highlight reel filled, you know, finish that we've been seeing a lot of these fights. But that just goes to show you put two talented fighters against each other, they cancel each other out, and that's what we're seeing right now.
But the other thing I can't understand is why isn't Fatui really going in with strikes? I've never seen her like really throw some punches.
I don't know that she's thrown more than 10 strikes this whole fight. I mean,
not even a single leg kick. I'm not sure about that.
It's definitely something she's going to have to add to her game if she wants to be successful in the sport.
Yeah. So here we go.
She's really a good grappler, but she needs to combine, use more her strikes.
It's time.
Sometimes it be like that. They're still fighting hard.
Time's off, ladies.
So now the big question is, how does that point deduction work into our overall score?
Yeah.
I still got Sengul winning the fight.
But Titus, I don't think it would change. In my opinion, Sengul took the fight. Every round, she win every round.
Yeah, just too much. I mean, Fatui, there's a combination, but for the majority of the fight, it was her going for the clinch, her going for the takedown. And there you go, right on the money for the Moxie
champ. I don't think she took down once. She was stopped.
Yeah, she kept going for takedowns.
Every single try. So.
Yeah, always takedowns, going for takedowns, yeah.
So, you know, Steve, the takedown defense should count as well. So
hey,
only the attack.
Let's see what the
judge she's celebrating.
We're going to have the official defender from Cyrus Face.
I'm really sure the single one. But hands up for these two ladies. What amazing fight. A lot of pressure for both sides. Amazing fight.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three hard fought rounds, we go to the judges' scorecard for the decision. All three judges see it the same. 29-27 for your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, the Turkish fighter, Sabriya Sengul.
Yeah, just like we thought.
And now presenting the award, Sabriya Sengul is our GM of UAE Warriors, Fuad Tarwish.
Another one.
We stack it up to the ceiling.
More money.
Getting her first victory in the ring.
More money.